Pennsylvania's Laurel Highlands, a haven of sparkling waterways, rolling countryside, natural wonders, and pristine mountains. Pennsylvania's Laurel Highlands, a place of wonder in any season. More information at laurelhighlands.org.
See a problem? See it green. Wastewater is not wasted at the Powdermill Nature Reserve. Their marsh machine takes wastewater and, well, just watch and you'll see.
This room that we're in is our marsh machine, and this is the wastewater treatment system for this entire building. Anything that goes down a drain, whether it be from a restroom, a kitchen sink, the dishwasher, will end up in this system. This system is unique in that it uses only plants and bacteria to purify wastewater. That's it. There's not much that we have to add to this system. It sort of takes care of itself. This is a similar process to a natural wetland, and we wanted to show that this is a way that wetland plants can purify water just with their roots. So this entire greenhouse is filled with thousands of gallons of water, and it's all hidden below our feet. The gravel that's below my feet is 4 feet deep here in the marsh, and if I dig down, I'll eventually hit the water level. It's about 10 inches below the surface. The gravel acts as a filter as the water passes through, and it helps to filter through the bacteria, and they actually will grow on the different types of gravel under here. The plants are simply rooted in the gravel, so this helps to hold the plants in place and act as a filter as the water passes through the different stages in the greenhouse. And they are now purifying it to be recycled back into our restrooms as clean flush water. These three tanks are called aquaculture tanks, and they transport water using gravity with this pipe in front of me here. The bacteria that live in these tanks are fed an oxygen supply so that they grow faster, which will help them treat the water faster. And the plants that are floating in the water here help to treat that water as well. The structure behind me is our ultraviolet light filter. This will send water through the inside of this tube where there is an ultraviolet light bulb that will zap the water and will deactivate the DNA from bacteria and harmful pathogens or even algae so that it doesn't continue to grow when it gets recycled into our restrooms. So this is an important stage of the process that is just using an ultraviolet light bulb, which is confined in this tube right here. We've been operating for about a year and a half, and this system has recycled 33,000 gallons of water back into the restroom facilities, which means we did not have to take that water from the groundwater supply. So we've conserved over 33,000 gallons of water using our marsh machine wastewater treatment system. Some uses for a marsh machine would be in an area that has a low water shortage at some point during the year. You can conserve the groundwater supply by having this. Also, areas that are not allowed to build septic systems, this is an alternative way to treat your wastewater, and you could just keep recycling it in a circle just using these plants. People that may be interested in this would not be your average homeowner because you have to have a certain size system, but universities can use this to treat dormitories. People that live in rural communities, you can have trailer park communities hook into this system to utilize this. Anywhere that you have a shortage of water, this is a great application, but it needs to be for more than just a single home. Extra water produced in our marsh machine is sent out to this living stream exhibit. The trout that we have in here are brook trout, and they're very sensitive to changes in water quality. We also have different insects that we put in here during certain times of the year. We have stoneflies, mayflies, caddisflies. These are things that the trout feed on in the wild. If the water quality is not pristine, those insects can't survive, which means the trout won't be able to live in there. So all the different factors combined in water quality lead to the successful, healthy habitat of some of our native fish populations. So everything comes together in this stream exhibit to showcase that our marsh has purified that water to an exceptional value stream. When people first see this exhibit, they just see it as a nice fish tank. They like to watch the fish. When they realize that these fish are actually living in recycled toilet water, it sort of blows their mind. They never would expect that our marsh would actually purify the water that well. And these fish are happy living in there, and people don't know the difference.
Now that's a good example of cleaning up after yourself. Check out the GreenLife website for great ideas about how you can improve our environment.